As a student, teacher, researcher, I know three times over how tricky it can be finding good sources on Google. If you want to direct your search to more precise and credible information, you're going to have to start using something Google calls search operators. Thankfully, they're not as complicated as they sound. Let's take a look. So here we are in Google search, and I want to start with one of my favorite search operators, which is just simply quotation marks. So you know that when you do a Google search, say for a line you read in a poem, what Google does is it just does a general search for those words, maybe in the order, maybe not, and they pull up some results they think are relevant. Here they're really picking up this wind rose. I, however, know that this is a line from something I read that I want to use as a source or want to find more about who's written about that line, for instance. So what you do is you surround it in quotations and tell Google, look for these words in this exact order completely. And you'll see, once I do that, I immediately start getting results for what this line is from, which is a poem by Philip Larkin. This suddenly opens up a whole new world of research for me, where I can start narrowing down this to see if anyone's done a close reading of this line, or I can just append Larkin to it to make sure that I'm getting all results for Philip Larkin and his poem. It's a great way, if you kind of have an idea of what you're looking for, to really tell Google, I know what I'm doing, search for these specific words in this order. So back on the Google search screen here, and I want to introduce you to my second favorite operator, which is the OR operator. So say you're looking into a topic like climate change. You're going to get a bunch of resources here that you can search through, but you start to realize that, oh yeah, other people refer to climate change as global warming, and you want results for authors and sources talking about either or. So what you do is you take the word, put or in all capital letters, then type in global warming, and this will tell Google to return results for either climate change or global warming. Now you have a more expansive list to draw from. Now let's talk about the hyphen or minus symbol. This can be handy when you're searching for a term like apple that has double or multiple meanings. So say you're looking for sources on the company Apple, but when you type apple into Google search, you get other results for cider mills or the fruit or whatever. What you can do is type apple, telling Google that that's the search term you want to look into, but then minus fruit. And that lets Google know that, give me search results for apple, but without any reference to fruits. And then you'll see the results start to really focus in for you. The final search operator I want to introduce you to is a bit more detailed because it has multiple uses, and that's the cite colon operator. So what you can do with this is, say you particularly like a source or you want to search within one source to find something, you can use cite colon and then the website address or domain of the source and then type in your search term. And what this will do is tell Google to search within the site NewYorkTimes.com about the term single-payer healthcare. And then you'll see all of our results are for the New York Times. Another cool trick with this, especially for student researchers, is if you're looking for really reliable information, one of the best places to look are for universities and academic institutions. And if you want to just get results on single-payer healthcare from those kinds of sites and sources, you can use cite colon and then the domain suffix .edu. which is just for academic institutions. You'll see when we then click into the search here, we get results on single-payer healthcare just from .edu domains. The third way to use this is by country code. So say you're looking into something like the Syrian refugee crisis, and you want to get perspectives from outside of wherever you're located. For instance, I'm in the US, and I want to get more perspectives on the Syrian refugee crisis. So I know one of those perspectives I'd like to get is from Germany. Well, Germany domains end in .de. So we can use the site colon .de and tell Google to search, like we did with .edu, for just .de German sites about this search term. You'll see we get a whole bunch of sources from Germany on the Syrian refugee crisis. This is an excellent way when you're doing research to get out of your national bubble and get sources that are perhaps more close to topics you're looking into. Now that you have a few of these tricks down, start combining them to get even better results. And of course, Googling's only gonna get you so far, so visit a library or use a library's online resources. I'd also love to hear some of your tricks for Google search. Add them into the comments.